Well, let me introduce to you the block. This is the overall pattern of the quilt we're making. You don't really have to worry about it that much yet, because I'm going to learn you how to do the compilation in December. But it is important to understand what the size of the different blocks should be, because in this module I will learn you how to make 5 basic blocks, namely the flying geese, this one, the pinwheel quilt, this one, the Roman square, which is this one, the log cabin, which is this one, and the 9 patch, which you actually already know from the A to Z lessons, but I want to explain it anyway for the people who are new. So a lap quilt can also be used for a baby quilt, and making it for a specific person in mind, which is a little bit secret, but anyhow. And the size, usually if you want to make a lap quilt combination with baby quilt, is 120 by 150 centimeters, because this size you can also use it when your baby is grown up a bit, and I like to make multi-purpose quilts. So I draw a raster for you with the size blocks in it, like, and this is 12 by 15 blocks, so every little square is 1 centimeter, like this. Every block is 1 by 1 centimeter, which also means that the quilt is divided in several blocks of 3 by 3 centimeters, like this. It's clearly early. Which means that, for example, this one, all the squares fit in a block of 30 by 30 centimeters. This is important to remember when you determine the size of your blocks. I will show you how to make it in the exact sizes as I've drawn here. But if you want to deviate from my plan, make sure that every block fits within the 30 by 30 centimeter square. Otherwise you get into problems later. So, okay. And as you can see, this one is bigger, but it consists of 4 of the 30 by 30 centimeters, because it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's 6 by 6, so it's basically 4 of those blocks, and then it's okay. And this one also deviates a little bit from it, but it's a whole length, so it's basically 15 blocks by 3, so then it's also okay. So this is how the drawing works. This is sort of an introduction. I will try to give you a drawing plate of this one. I've used paint, but the result is a little bit confusing. So I will try to make a drawing so you can color in any way you want and determine your color choices. Or you can go crazy if you want. I will explain to you the colors in another video. I think this is everything you need to know for now.